नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श छू। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी।
हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टडी द क्वेश्चन नंबर 7 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 9.5। दिस इज द टॉपिक ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 8, चैप्टर नंबर 9, एल्जेब्रिक एक्सप्रेशंस एंड आइडेंटिटीज। सो व्हाट इज द क्वेश्चन? क्वेश्चन इज यूजिंग ए स्क्वायर माइनस बी स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू ए प्लस बी a minus b, find. Here we have given the four sub questions. So here we have to use the identity number 3, that is a square minus b square is equals to a plus b, a minus b. So the first sub question here given is that 51 square minus 49 square. This is the first question we have to solve using this identity. See, here we can see that a square and b square is there, and here also 51 square and 49 square is there. So we can replace here a with 51 and b with 49. So here we can write down it as a 51 plus 49, and in another bracket 51 plus 49, right? So the addition here we get is 9 plus 1 10 0 1 is the carry. Here we get the 100, and here in the multiplication here we have to take the minus sign, so here we get the 2. So the answer we are getting is equals to 200, right? So here we can see that it is very easy to calculate the subtraction of the square of the two numbers, right? What will happen if we do this method? If we find out the square of 51, then we find the square of the 49, then we subtract it, then it will be very tedious process, right? It will be hard process. But here, using this identity, we can easily solve this question. Okay, let us see one more question, that is second number. Here we have to find out the 1.02 square minus 0.98 square. See, here also, if we apply the square here and here, then we subtract, then it will be lengthy process. Let us use this identity. We can write down in one bracket the addition of both number, in another bracket we have to subtract both the numbers. So here we can write down 1.02 plus 0.98. This is the value in the first bracket. In another bracket, 1.02 minus 0.98. This is the value in the second bracket. Now, addition of both these numbers. See, 8 plus 2, that is 10, 0 is there, 1 is the carry. 9 plus 1, 10, 10 plus 0, 10, again 0 is there, 1 is the carry. 1 plus 0 plus 1, that is 2. Addition of both these numbers we get is equals to 2. What is the subtraction we are getting here is 1.02 minus 0.98. We can calculate like this: 1.02 minus 0.98. So here we have to take 10, here we have to take 9, here we have to cut 1, and we have to put 0. So 12 minus 8, that is 4, 9 minus 9, 0, 0.04. Now what is the answer? Final answer is we have to multiply 2. Here we can write down simply this as a 2, and we have to multiply it with 0.04. We know that 4 to the 8, so our answer will be 0.08. This is the final answer. Okay, now third one is 153 whole square minus 147 whole square. Okay, again we have to apply the same identity. In first bracket we have to add both the numbers, 153 plus 147. In another bracket we have to to subtract both numbers 153 minus 147. So here we get, what we are getting, 7 plus 3 is 10, 0, 1 is the carry, 4 plus 1, 5, 5 plus 5, again 10, 0, 1 is the carry, 2 and 3. Here we get the 300, and here what we are getting, 153 minus 147. So 3 plus 3, 6 we are getting here, and 6 threes are 18. So 1800 is our final answer, right? So using this identity number 3, we can calculate this type of sum. Now let us study the question number 8. Here we have to use the identity x plus a and x plus b. X plus b. What we can write down, if there is an identity, this is actually identity number 4. We can write down here is x square plus a plus b into x plus a. This is the identity. Right? So, first sub question we have to solve using this identity is 103 multiplication 104. Right? So, here we have the two numbers 103 and 104. We have to make this, we have to rearrange this 103 and 104 like this. So, here we can write down it as a 100 plus 3, and here we can write down it as a 100 plus 4, right? So now see, both these brackets are arranged like this. Here first term is same, here also 100 same. A and B are different, in the same way 3 and 4 are different. So we can now consider x is equals to 100, a is equals to 3, and b is equals to 4. Put down all the values here. You have to make the square of first term, that is the common in both, that is 100. So 100 square. Then we have to add both the numbers a and b, that is here in our case 3 and 4. 3 plus 4. We have to multiply it with the common number, that is 100. And then we have to multiply both the numbers a and b. So 3 and 4. 3 and now we have to simplify it and find out our answer. So 100 square is 10,000 plus. Here what we get, 4 plus 3 is equals to 7. 7 into 100, that is 700. And here we get 4 threes are 12. Now add all the numbers. We get the 2 plus 0 plus 0, 2, 1 plus 0 plus 0, 1, 7 plus 0, 7, and 10. So here we get the answer 10,712. Right? So this is the multiplication of 103 and 104. Right? So here using only 3-4 steps we can calculate this value. Actually when we do the multiplication, then it may be sometime you make some of the mistakes, so you got the wrong answer. But here we get the actual answer, perfect answer. Right? Now let us study one more question. That is the second number with decimal numbers 5.1 into 5.2. Right? So here how we can make two brackets? We can write down it as a 5 plus 0.1 and 5 plus 0.2. Right? We have to arrange the numbers such that the first number become equal, second number may be different, right? So here second one is different, but first one in both the brackets are equal. So we can write down 5 as a x, we can take 0.1 as a and 0.2 as a b. Now we have to apply this identity, square of the first term, that is 5 square, plus add both the numbers 0.1 plus 0.2 and multiply it with this x. X means 5. And here we have to multiply both these numbers 0.1 and 0.2. 0.1, 0.2. Now let us simplify. Here we get the 5 5s are 25. What is the value we are get? 0.1 plus 0.2 is 0.3, and 0.3 into 5, that is 5 3s are 15. But we have to put one decimal point. So here we get the 1.5. Here also 0.1 into 0.2. So now we can think it like 1 upon 10 into 2 upon 10. That means 2 ones are 2 in the numerator, denominator there is 100. So 2 upon 100, that means 0.02. 0.02. Right? Now you can do this thing in your mind. No need to write down, right? Okay. Okay. Now add all the numbers. After decimal point, there are 2 decimal places, right? But this one is the only 2. So here 2 will remain as it is. 0 plus 5, that is 5. Now before decimal places, 0 plus 1, that is equals to 1. 1 plus 5, 6. And 2 is there. So 26.52 is the multiplication of 5.1 into 5.2. Okay, let us see one more. Third one. That is 103 multiplied by 98. Okay, now here also we have to make the brackets so that first term remains same. So here we can write down it as a 100 plus 3, and here 100 minus 2, right? Here we have to take the minus value. So now what will happen? See, x is our 100. A, we can take 3, but here B must be positive. B must be positive, but here we get the negative value. So we can do one thing here. We can write down it as a 100 plus 3 and 100 minus of minus 2. Plus of minus 2. What we have to do? We put this minus 2 into the bracket and we put positive sign before that bracket. Now see, plus minus multiplication of positive and negative is negative. So we are getting 100 minus 2. Right? We have just write down in another form. So that now our B plus B, that means plus minus 2. That means B is minus 2. We have to consider B as a negative 2, minus 2. Now let us calculate as usual. First of all, we have to apply the square of this 100. So first bracket is square of 100. In second bracket, we have to add both these numbers, 3 plus minus 2. 3 plus minus 2, because B is minus 2. And we have to multiply it with 100. And now we have to multiply both this A and B. A is 3 and B is minus 2. Right? Okay. Now the square of this is 10,000. See, here what will happen? Plus minus minus. 3 minus 2 is 1. 1 into 100 is 100. So here simply we get the 100. And what we get here is 3 2s are 6, but plus minus minus. Minus 6. So we have to add these numbers and subtract 6 from this. So when we subtract here, let us write down 10,000 as it is. 100 minus 6, we can write down as a 94. And the addition of both this number we get is equals to 10,094. Right? So this is the final answer. So you can see that the identities that we have studied are very useful to find out the multiplication of numbers as well as multiplication of the algebraic expressions. So these four identities that we have studied, that is very useful. You have to remember it because it is useful in also standard 9, standard 10. Okay, so this is all about this lecture. Thank you.
Thank you for joining us.